And welcome to PCSimulators.org in association with PCHelicopters.com. Today, as you can see, there's a helicopter on your screen and we are going to look at Take On Helicopters. Some of you may have heard of it, some of you may not have heard of it. And this game has got a lot of options. We had a lot of fun making this video and I hope you enjoy it. We are going to go through the single player, multiplayer options, and all the other bits and bobs that come with it. So stay tuned and we'll start in the next few minutes with looking at the training option. Okay, we're back. So as you can see, this is the helicopter. It's nice graphics, very good graphics. And we're going to go into a starting procedure to start the helicopter. So like I said, I've got track IR working as well with the sim. And if you have problems with track IR, let me mention it before we go on, is if you click on the escape button, go to options and go to game options, controls, click on controls, and then you see that you got a controller option down here. So if you click on controller, make sure that you enable track IR. So if you click on it, you can either disable it or enable it. By default it's disabled, so if you have track IR, make sure number one is on, and then number two, you enable it through this configure controllers menu. If you don't, you won't be able to use it and you'll just be wondering what's going on. So yet again, controls, click on controls, click on controller, and then click on track IR and then enable it. Okay, so let's get back into the cockpit and carry on with what we're doing. So click on continue. So right, first of all, it's saying that the automatic start is activated from the menu. Okay, so if we use the mouse wheel, we can see similar to Arma 3, where you've got the met option in the top left hand corner. If you look where the frame rate is, you can click on an engines on. So click on engines on automatically, and we're going to wait for the engine to start. Here I'm starting, and now it's saying wait for the automatic startup procedure to complete. We can zoom in on this. Can we move that track IR? Nope, goes a bit funny. And now we are waiting for the procedure to complete. And this is the external view, you can see. It hasn't got a great deal of options for the external view, which is a bit disappointing. So you've got one camera angle, which I'm actually using the pneumatic keypad to see, to scroll down, up and down. There you go. And let's get back in. You can press enter on the pneumatic keypad and that gets you in and out of the helicopter. So okay, let's turn on the auto hover. So the auto hover can be activated pressing auto hover on the action menu, with the action menu being the top left. So you scroll your middle mouse button. So you scroll your mouse wheel and you get your options, and to select the option you press the mouse button in, sorry, the wheel in, and now it's saying that the lever to lift the helicopter is the collective, and it's found on the left hand side. So let's have a look at the collective that's found on the left hand side. You can see it, they're lifting it up. Okay, so we're going to increase the collective and take off. So here we go. Let's look at the collective. Let's lift it up slightly, slowly. And we're off. There you go. So we're taking off. So look from outside. That's us. Oh! So we're auto hovering at the moment. So press Q to increase the collective. We've got to go to 100 meters. Let's see if we can go a bit higher. Now see, the graphics are pretty good. They're not bad at all. So now we're going to climb lower. So we're going to lower. So we're going to push the collective down, or the Z key. I've got my collective mapped to the CH throttle pro. Okay, so we're going to descend to 50 meters, and we've done it. So that's a quick example of one of the training scenarios. So we're not going to go through every single training scenario. Let's just have a look at the free flight now. So you can see the graphics are pretty good. And can we move away now from here? Let's see. Let's turn auto hover off. So auto hovering is off. And it does handle pretty well. It's very twitchy actually, so it's not forgiving like FSX helicopter, so it is pretty sensitive. As you can see, I'm just applying a little bit too much movement into my joystick, so because I've just been flying the Bell 47 and FSX, and obviously there's a lot more forgiving. But this is a bit like between the Gazelle and the Huey really for DCS, but it's very, very sensitive control. So you can see that the controls move just a little bit, and look, you go right to the left there quite easily. So let's have a look. Oh, do you see that? Look at that, they're straightened out. So it's very, very sensitive. You have to be very wary of that. Okay, so we're gonna, I mean, the terrain isn't great, you see, it's not great, but the helicopter itself and the water's pretty good, but it's a bit blurred. For example, look at the grass, it's on high res and very high resolution, so at the end of the day, you know, it's not as if it's on low quality, but it's okay. It's not great. The flight model's pretty good though. I like the flight model. So let's see if we can hover again. That's the space bar. We can auto hover. Have a look around. There's our co-pilot. Look, hello there. He actually turned. Oh my god, he looks like a zombie. Okay, so let's press enter again. Let's have a little look outside, and there is the helicopter that we just flying. So okay. That's the training tutorial. There's a lot more tutorials as well, which take you into things like engine, turning the engine on, and sort of looking at how the helicopter gets ready before takeoff. And on the right, yeah, you see it also tells you how what to do to bank and what bank means, etc. So, okay, without further ado, let's move on to the next section. Okay, now we look at the single player option again, and we'll click on the challenges. And we are going to click on Take on Heinz and click on Open, and we're going to go for the Lucky Dip. So let's click on that and restart. Okay, click on restart, and we'll shortly be flying a Hind. So here we are, and now we've got to board that helicopter, so let's run over to it. You can, of course. There you go, there's that awesome helicopter, as you can see. So, well modelled, isn't it? That's the Hind. See if I can show you around. Fantastic. Look, really good graphics, mine. Very well presented. So you can also, if you move your mouse over, and this can be a bit finicky. Hello, who are you? Oh, God, you just pushed in. Okay, so if you move the mouse over, and let me just disable my track IR. So you should see some spots where you can check things. As it, you know, check the guns. Is it? Nope, sorry about that. Oh, my menu's in the wrong place. Okay. So if I move over to here, you see that? Now, if I move my mouse over, click on open, see, it opens the door. And then, I don't know what happened there. Can you close it? I don't know, they won't let me close it now. So, it's a bit finicky, that. Okay, let's go back to the back. See if we can check the actual helicopter itself. There we go, we got a light, and if you click on that, it means you've checked the helicopter. So, there you go, check that, the stabilizer's working. And it's very tricky to get that, actually, that mouse cursor on what you need to check. So, there you go, let's see if I can just get in the fly. Oh, yep. Check the inspect the tail rotor. Yep, that's working. Okay. What else do I have to do? Yep, check that. Horizontal stabilizer's working. So you see, when you've got that green sort of circle, it means you can check the helicopter. Okay, that's guns. We'd want to check that. And can we get in now? We've got more to check. Oh, yeah. That means you can get in. So he's getting in. And now we're going to start the helicopter. So I'm going to press the right arrow, and you get a menu option at the top there, in the top left, you see, and go to engines on.
Switching batteries on. Starting APU.
There he is.
Holding starter for engine one. Throttle to idle for engine one.
So we're on manual fire. Engines are on. Ready to go.
Raising starter for engine 1. Holding starter for engine 2. Throttle to idle for engine 2.
Oh.
Releasing starter for engine 2. Shutting down APU. Initiating warm-up.
Let's put the track air back on. Still waiting for the warm-up. Taking a long time to take off. That's the outside view of my helicopter. Yeah, we're off. And we go in. Here we go. So we're finally off the ground. And they said we've got to follow a flight path.
This is November 1. Proceeding to Point Alpha.
Point Alpha. There you go. On the right-hand side of my screen, it says 3 kilometers. So we are going to head towards that. Well, it did say 3 kilometers. No, it disappeared. The reflections are good. The sunlights are good. The reflections of the sun on top of the windshield. Actually moving, doesn't look like I'm moving, yes, I think I am now. That's the view of the Hind. Should we track the gears? Nope, that's the map. So I'm zooming a bit closer, there you go, what a great sight. I did leave the window open and it's still open now. Can you see the window open? Great looking helicopter, isn't it? Go back inside. I'm not sure where it's supposed to be going at the moment, actually, so I'm just going to sort of turn it around and see if I can find where I am supposed to be going. Look at the dirty window as well. So you've got the dirty window. Good effect. A poor guy must be freezing underneath. Ah, we are. There's a radar on the top, in the top left-hand corner. I presume that's where I've got to follow. Also, don't forget, there's Air Missions Hind, which is actually concentrates on the Hind helicopter, and that is available on Steam, still in early access, so be sure to look out for that one. We're thinking of doing a review for that too. So, does it actually look like I'm moving here? I don't know. Am I moving or not? Yeah, I am moving. Does it actually give me the feeling that I'm moving? So, go a bit lower so I can see what's going on with relation to the ground. Yes, I'm moving. It didn't look like it was moving at all there. And yeah, it's not easy to control the helicopter on Veteran. It's up there just underneath DCS and X-Plane, I think, for the authenticity of how it feels like in a amongst all the Premier helicopter sims. It's probably a little bit underrated, this game. I suppose after people watch this video, they might have a look at it and just try it out. It is available on Steam. I don't know where it's supposed to be going here, but there's the sun shining in. You can see all the dirty marks on the window, so that's a good touch. Again, track IR is not too great in the cockpit because it's quite jerky, but you can set track IR to be less sensitive. I know that, but it's sort of difficult to go back a bit. If there was a move back control, it'd be a bit easier, so you can zoom up, but I haven't seemed to be able to find that that control yet. Okay, so that's the Hind helicopter that we're looking at the moment. So let's go back to our main menu and click on continue. No, we don't want to do that. We want to suspend. Is it suspend? Okay, back to the main menu. So we're going to have like another option here. We're going to click on challenge. Okay, and we're going to go to, let's have a look, Hello Seattle. Here we go, take a group of tourists around the tour of Seattle. So we're going to try that one. So the amount of missions that you get, the amount of options you've got, it's quite good. It's a lot of options in the game, like a flight simulator, because you haven't got all
those
options.
Welcome to our flight. Today, I'll be taking you through some interesting places in the city.
Okay, mate. Is that it? Right. So, so a lot of options in this game compared to other flight sims. You've got a lot of missions. You've got a career mode. And there's a helicopter that we're going to fly off now with. And we are in the cockpit, ready to go. Let's auto-start the engine to make things easier. And wait for that to start. The cockpit is clickable as well. And while we wait for that to start, it's going to be outside you. And there is our copter, our rotary bird. See the dust effect that you get as well as it's taking off. That's a good touch. The camera controls do leave a lot to be desired. I mean, I'm holding a key here, the plus key. You can zoom in. It won't stay zoomed in. As soon as I let go, it goes out. Enter gets you back in the cockpit on the numeric keypad. And enter on the numeric keypad gets you outside. So, it leaves a lot to be desired. I mean, I wish it just have set views that you got in X-Plane or FSX where you just select the view you want. It's not that easy in this one, which is a bit of a shame. And there's no replay either. But I haven't found one anyway. So, okay. Ready for liftoff? Here we go. So here we go. Ready for liftoff. Let's zoom out. See, I want to zoom out a bit. Ah, now it's stayed up. Look. Fantastic. That's better. So the minus key on the keyboard allows me to zoom out. Oh, no. It's gone back in now. Yeah. Press it twice. So off we go. Let's go towards our Seattle over there. Our city. Oops. A bit too quick there with the pedal. A bit oversensitive there. So that's a good sign, really, to show you that the game isn't that straightforward, like you could just take off quite easily. It has got a lot of good physics to it. The Rotolib engine is the one that they're using for the helicopter physics, and it does model vortex ring state. So a bit of a crap takeoff there, I must admit, but I wasn't concentrating. So here we go. And let's go towards our destination over there into the city. There we go, we're on our way. Should I be doing this? I'm gonna fly it? No, I shouldn't, but there you go. I'm doing it anyway. I'm trying to fly from an external view. And it's gonna mess it up if I don't be careful. Whoa, as I said. We're a little all over the place, he's correct, so we are. So let's move over to the right and then back to the left and turn around a bit. Yes, I know. It's all wobbling. Why is it still wobbling though? I don't know. It must be air turbulence. It's funny though, because when I center my pedals, I wonder if I've broken anything. I think I might have broken something. Oh dear. I think we need to land. I think that something's damaged on the aircraft. It's not settling down, is it? So it looks like it's simulating damage to an aircraft, which is what's happened here. So we're going to try and slow the aircraft down and land. Bleed a bit of speed off. And there's Seattle below. The judgment hasn't gone away, has it?
Close to the two famous skyscrapers, the Columbia Center and Smith Tower.
It was actually tenants as well.
Smith Tower has 38 floors and even includes a fallout shelter which can be seen from the entrance hall.
No, can I get in closer? Well, I'm struggling here, buddy. I'm trying, but the helicopter somehow is jerking everywhere and he just wants me to go a bit closer to that skyscraper. Okay, what he wants. Anyway, I'm going to concentrate on trying to land somewhere because I think this is not working. It's a copter, so let's try and land it. He's telling me to get a better angle on the helicopters, judging like mad. I'm going to pull up a bit to flare, slow the helicopter down, and use the collective as well to reduce a bit more speed. So we're going lower and slower. Can you keep us steady? What a knob. Daddy, see, there's something wrong with it. We're going to try and get around this building. Oh dear God. Ah, where are we? Come on, slow down a bit more. And we've landed. At least we managed to land into the city. So, good landing. Something wrong with a helicopter. Oh, the car's gone straight through us. But that gives you an idea of one of the challenges. They got on target in the top right hand corner. 3% scores you, so you know what you're doing and where you are. But for some strange reason, my helicopter was juggling. Oh my good God, he went straight through us. Great stuff. You see, there's a lot of fun involved in this. Okay, let's go back here and suspend that, and we're going to have a look at something else. So that's the challenges you've got anyway. So we've got a few challenges there. We just did one of those time trials. Let's have a look at the time trials. Let's see, bridge too far, track above the path. Oh, we've done that one. Oh, let's try this one. Find your way above the trees and dive into a shallow valley. So okay, we'll have a look at that in a sec. Okay, so we're going to do the Wild Wild East. Here we go. Click play. And we're going to have a time trial going through some hoops, starting here, through here, and here, 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 here. And then we're going to beat these times if we can. And click on continue. So here's the first hoop. Let's go through there. It's a bit too close to start with, isn't it? We haven't done it, so we have to go back. Oh dear. Didn't give us much time to line up there. I suppose they're so close and too high. So let's go around and see if we can do it again. Let's see if we can get through that hoop a bit easier. Let's slow the helicopter down a little bit. Slow it down, down a bit. Let's do a quick turn. Gently does it. There we go. Let's try again. There's better. Line up correctly now. Don't believe we can get this right. Gently does it. So it's quite difficult, it's quite tricky actually, to get the helicopter on target. And you were a bit too close just now, so that's one. That's checkpoint to one. Now the next checkpoint over there, as you can see, 900 meters away. We lost time at the beginning though, so we're not going to probably beat any of those times that we've just set, that were set earlier by somebody else. Let's go for this checkpoint. Gentle touches on the controls, it's very sensitive. Just over the trees as well, look. Oh no, don't go funny on me now. There we go. Next checkpoint. It's quite challenging actually. And you only got to move the helicopter control slightly and it just... Obviously, if you do too much, you end up way off course. Like, I think I'm just done now, so... Let's see. Can I get into this circle quite easily now? No, I missed it. So I've got to go around again. It's exactly what I'm just saying. It's very, very difficult to control that, the different directions you have to take. So it is a challenge. Let's go and do that again. see if we can somehow get the helicopter to go through that hoop without having to go too far away. And yes, I did that. So next checkpoint. Let's slow down, I think. Oh, it's drifting the wrong way, And we're going to hit the floor. We're not going to hit the floor. Challenge it. The trees are below very good, aren't they? So, let's see if we can get this. Oh, just missed it. We're gaining too much speed now, so we have to bleed that off a bit. It's a challenge, I'm telling you now. You may think it looks easy, but it's not. It's quite challenging, really. So, let's go back and try again. Speed up, look at that sunlight, it's fantastic, isn't it? Great stuff. I'm liking this sim quite a lot, actually. A few niggles, but I like it, it's a lot of things to do in it. Here we go, there's it down there, so we need to lower our collective a little bit more. Go backwards a bit. That's better. So if we can line it up. So we can perfectly pass through it. There you go. That looks better, doesn't it? That's better. Okay, again, another one. So the next one's 1.4 kilometers away. I don't know what our time's going to be, but it's not going to be probably in the goal time, is it? A few mishaps on the way. Line this up just above the trees. It's slight touches on the collective, slight touches on the cyclic, and goes a long way. So here we go towards our next point. Shame I've got a replay. I'd like to see a replay of this, but I don't think there is a replay in this. I haven't seen one. Do it. I don't want to go wrong again. There you go. That's it. Perfect. And the next checkpoint is over there. Is it behind the mountain? I can't see. Yes, look at that. Right in the valley. Oh, God. Here we go. Oh, just over this rock. Keep it steady. Then we're going to get a super fast time, that's all, that's for sure. Just a bit jerk there on the collective, being a bit too low. That's better, it's more smoother now. That one, how many checkpoints we've got to do. It does really teach you how to be a bit more lighter on the controls, so I suggest if you do get this game to try this. It does actually give you a better idea of how to control the helicopter at certain speeds and heights, so it's very good practice. Slight touches of the collective and the cycling. I think we're going to be a little bit off here, are we? No, maybe not. Maybe we can just about do it. Yes, we can. As Bob the Builder says. A bit more collective now. And that's our next spot over there. Climb a bit higher for this one. A bit of a toughie. You can see the next one there as well behind the mountain. They're all strategically placed, aren't they? These are. Don't want to miss this one, do we? Oh, yes, that's it, we did it. So overstretch ourselves now. Well, come on. We're playing well up there. So let's go for this hoop. And oh, I think we messed this one up a bit. Wait. Line here, so we have to go back. Let's try and start again. Let's turn around. Messed that up a bit, didn't we? Well, I. Let's line this out up again. Doing well up to that point. It's a very awkward spot now because it's got a bit of a slope there as well. And the bend, so oh, just missed it. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's frustrating. So let's go around again. Gonna get this one. It kills me. So awkward, that is so awkward. Right. Okay, try again. No, it still hasn't given it to me. You sod. I thought that was a clean through then. That's the problem, you miss one and you're stuck. And you left going wrong in circles, aren't you? Like, let's try again. Okay. Let's see, from the corner of my eye, I'm going to have another go. This time, we've done it. God, that's so tricky that one was. Let's keep on cue here. Concentration levels difficult. You really gotta concentrate, really. And that one's a bit in the air as well. Different heights, different angles. There we go, we did it! Fantastic! So, that was tough. But didn't beat any of the target times. But good, it's good. Okay, so that is the time, the challenges, and especially the time trials. So now we're going to finally look at the career mode and wrap it up with that. So click on career, and we're going to click continue. We're only going to do a part of this, a few minutes of this, because otherwise the video will be too long. So click on start. So the game has got lots of options, it's got lots of missions, it's got lots of challenges. It handles quite well as a helicopter simulator, surely a lot better than default FSX helicopters. And okay, so I didn't click play, did I? And I do think it's a great game. I think it's got something that other simulators haven't got, the career mode, and the said all the other options you can use with it. So, and it's got marvelous selection of helicopter. The graphics are great. Downsides are at the moment the cockpit zooming in and out is a bit like a limited, and the camera controls are quite poor, really. So this is the this is the career mode. To be predictable here, it's the rain, right? So he's saying, look, there's a bit of an intro sequence here where he's where's he going? It looks like a storm's gathering, he says. If there's one thing that's supposed to be predictable here, it's the rain, right? Okay, that's what we got at the moment. That's the helicopter. Oh, am I supposed to be flying that? No, I'm not. He's flying it, is he? Yes, he is. It's an automate. So it looks like he's doing something with that.
You know, I've got to thinking. It's been a while since Dad took you up for your lessons. God, it's almost 6 years, right? Half a decade. Can you believe that? Here's an idea. What do you think about taking the controls? You know, just a quick spin. Get the feel of the thing again, yeah? Hey, don't look at me like that. It'll be fine, I promise.
He wants me to take control. Okay.
Right, then. You've got the controls, Tom.
Oh.
Okay, just hold a straight and level path.
There you go. So I'm going to hold a straight and level path. What would you do next?
See? You never forget, Tom. Just like riding a bike, right?
Oh, he's talking. Simi's talking.
Okay. Easy now, Tom. Easy. Good. I've got her now, bro.
Okay, so now we're going to enjoy the flight. Like the current task, enjoy the flight. So, this is his buddy here. Obviously, he must have known his dad. And he's taking over the controls. He's let us fly a little bit. And, he's now going to guide us somewhere by the looks of it, so wait and see what he does. While he does that, let's have a look at the external view. It's great graphics, isn't it? It's really good. I mean, it's not to the same standard of DCS, the modern, but it's pretty good. And it's a bit raw on some parts of the helicopter there, as you can see, but the noise is really good. It sounds excellent. The searchlight underneath there, look. And the reason this I'm doing this, I'm moving my track IR to the camera view, so... Where's he going now?
It's great to have you up here, Bill. Really, it is. And honestly, since Dad passed, been a real struggle on my own.
That's your brother.
With this economy, it's just way too tight to hire another pilot, you know? I guess what I'm saying is, I don't know.
In other words,
it's just real great to see you again, Tom.
He wants me to work with him again. That's what he wants me to do. So that's the story, you see. Basically, you go in as a pilot to help this fledging company and to get back on its feet again with your lot of missions and tasks. So it's something in the game as well as flying the helicopters, you've got some tasks to complete. So that's a good that's a good angle that they've taken.
Let's try again. Don't even think about that last time. Take the controls and just try a simple bank out towards the water. Easy. Okay, I'll take her from here again.
So, okay. Well, I don't want to go into too much into the story, but as you can see, that gives you an idea of what's going to be happening in the game. It obviously develops as you go along, so we'll end it there, because we're running out of time, and whoops, let's click on that, suspend, and hello, there you go. So, that's our review for Take on Helicopters. Like I said, we just went through a lot of the options that you had. The free flight, the career, the challenges, the time trials, the training. And we've covered all that. And a final verdict, well, as you can see on the screen, the graphics are very, very good. The sound of the helicopters is authentic. The flight model, based on the Rotolib model, they've confirmed to us that it does model VRS. And when I'm being flying, it certainly does feel a lot like X-Plane and DCS. About, I would say, 85 to 90% similar. DCS, and obviously to me, is the most authentic, I think, followed closely by X-Plane. And I would say this is either in third or fourth. I mean, Flight Gear has got a good flight model, and I haven't tried HDR yet, but having tried Flight Gear, X-Plane, FSX, DCS, I would say DCS definitely in first place, X-Plane slightly behind, in second, and a fly gear and this take on helicopters, I think I haven't decided who will be in third place. They're both there up there. And if you are interested in purchasing it, it's over on Steam, so have a look. And you won't be disappointed if you're a helicopter fan, that's for sure.